Hello to all my awesome viewers out there. Merry Christmas, happy holidays. Today is Christmas Eve 2022, and we are going to be building up, what more appropriately after the blizzards we've been having in Wisconsin this year, is the Moebius 1972 F250 Ford Ranger with snowplow. This is the four-wheel drive version with the complete snowplow package. Model Roundup sent this over for a full build review, so when you get up tomorrow morning, if Santa didn't leave this underneath the tree, head on over to modelroundup.com and snag this kit for yourself. You can build a standard 4x4 F250. You can build it with the plow attachment because it comes in the box. Let's start taking a look at all the plastic, and I mean all the plastic in this kit. This box is full from top to bottom and tight. If you take out all the parts, you're never going to get them all back in the right way. First up will be the crossbar for the frame. We've got our F250 suspension front and rear. We've got our transmission, transfer case, and you're always going to have a ton of extra parts in these kits. So don't be surprised that you have a complete buttload, which used to be a measurement of wine in old England, of parts left when you get done building a Moebius Ford Ranger pickup kit. So that's that tree right there. We've got the frame here. I've built numerous, I must have built at least a half a dozen of these on the show already, but I wanted to, the minute I saw they were making a snowplow one, had to build it up. Got our front and rear differentials, solid axle on this generation of the Fords. We've got multiple drive shafts for different iterations, and we've got that nice long one-piece frame, which helps ensure that you will build the vehicle straight, even though a lot of times I still build a tweak in them. We've got our interior. We've got the nice door panels here. You can see all the detail on them. And our bench seat. An F250, a basic work truck, is almost always just going to have a bench seat on it. We've got that nice hood with the Ford logo molded in. We've got our floor pan for the cab. We've got the back of the cab, which I think was also the gas tank in these trucks. Ford always liked putting the gas tanks in precarious positions. We've got the bed interior sides. The inner fenders there for the bed. There is so much plastic in this kit. We've got multiple intake valve cover options. When you go through the manual, you will pick out the options that are for the version that you are building. We've got our bed floor ribbed. We've got the bed sides ribbed. Nice crisp detail. I know they punch out a lot of these molds, and some of the previous ones I had mentioned had a little bit of flash, but not really noticing any on this one. So maybe they went in and cleaned them or make sure they were clamped a little tighter. We've got our firewall here, tailgate. This is actually the hood, the top of the radiator brace and all that. They even make that in this kit. This thing is a very modern kit, and it builds up as such. Here's our dashboard. Even got the radio molded in, the temperature controls. We've got our gauges molded in, and they usually include a decal. Got the inside of our tailgate there, or the cab. We've got our steering column with signal and shifter. We've got our wheel backs, shock absorbers. They've even got visors in this kit. 12-volt battery, jack, reservoir. I mean, look at these links, even. Now, like I said, some of the parts aren't used in certain kits, but they're always going to be in there. We've got our pedals, gas, brake, clutch, parking. Brake booster. This little thing is where you mount your pedals for either manual or standard transmission. So they think of everything. Got a utility rear bumper that's not chrome. That's always in these. Got our spare tire, and check it out. The bolt holes. Got an 8-bolt axle, and they're molded open on that spare tire. And we got our wheel backing plates, spare tire mount right there. Got our wheels, the proper number of bolts, with our hubs. See the little twist hubs? Such fine, fine detail for Moebius. Got the radiator just flying loose in mine, so I'll make sure to show that. We're still not done. We got our block halves. We got another tailgate option. We got a belt and pulley system. We got another intake and a fan. Like I said, depending on the engine that's with that kit, that's the parts you'll use, and the rest you can throw in the bed as junkyard salvage. Got our nice plastic tough steering wheel, starter oil filters, coil, water pump, cylinder heads. They think of everything. We've got our exhaust system here, one-piece exhaust. We're not going to have big fancy duals. Got the nice manifolds on there. PCV valves, if that need ones. Carburation, water pump, alternator, distributor. All the finest little details you come to expect. We got our lovely cab. Nice big side molding on there. Bottom molding is nice and crisp. You can see where the grill and everything just press in. It's not a precarious glue point. You just paint that black and it looks awesome. Got all the holes for the mirrors, for the cab handles. Got nice crisp molding for the drip rail, back of the cab. This makes sure that your cab's lined up on the frame. Oh yeah, yeah. Merry Christmas and the plow. This is a tree you wouldn't have seen in any other of my reviews before. We've even got all the hydraulics, the frame mounts, the attachment points. It's even got the lights, because you got to have the lights because the plow blocks the headlights. I mean, everything on there, the hydraulic ram system, the hydraulic pump, the springs when the plow hits stuff and it goes like that and it bounces around. It's even got those springs there. Check out the plow. It's got the wear blade with correct riveting across the front. Look at the back of it. Look at all the bracing. I don't know what brand that would be. I wonder if that's from one of the Wisconsin plow companies that were so famous in the 70s. Wausau Plow, Wausau Steel. Yes, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Let's switch to the other side of the table because that's not even close to being done. We've got our clear parts tree. These windshields fit extremely tightly in the Ford pickups. They just do. They have since the beginning, but they do fit. Back glass, vent windows, headlights and marker lights, etc. We've got transparent red taillights. We've got hubcaps, should you want to put them on, even with ones open for the front four-wheel drive hubs. We've got Ranger emblems. We've got cab lights. Looks like they give you an extra one in case you send it flying. It's got little attachment points. Let me look at that cab again. Sure enough, they've got, I don't know if you can see them, really shallow dimples for those cab lights. Yeah, it's not all the way through if you don't want to put them on. Very, very shallow. The two pins are for the visors. But yeah, you'll be able to drill those out and space out your cab lights without having to throw a fit. Got our rear, we got mirrors, more hubcaps, door handles. Another clear parts tree for the plow, I'm guessing. The lights for the plow. We've got that beautiful grill molded open. That's why you paint black behind it, like I said. What else we got over here? We got side trim. The side trim. Nicely done. You don't even have to chrome that. You just glue it right on down the side if you want to use it. Sweet. We got chrome bumpers. Definitely an option. We've got 1, 2, 3 mirror options for the truck. Decide which ones you want to bolt on. I've always liked this style. Never really liked the little ones. The big ones are nice on the work trucks too, but you decide. It's your kit. So you decide what mirror option you want. What else we got laying around over here? We've got a set of 5 semi-hollow plastivinyl tires with an absolute excellent prototypical bias ply big crisscross zigzag lug pattern. 5 of those because you got to have the spare. What else are we going to look at over here? We've got a bag of chain for the plow. Probably want to paint that. And we've got decals with, and you know this is a big stickler for me, they've included the Ford emblems in metallic for the grill. They've included them twice to make it extra nice. We've got door logos, Acme snow relocators, Ron's McKinley service station, South Bend, Indiana, engine decals, Ranger decals, and a fake wood grain tailgate decal. Excellent job, Moebius. on getting the individual letters for the hood. Excellent, you finally put them in there. The standard Moebius manual, this one's for the snowplow. Their manuals look like this. They have full color guides inside. Come on, they're super slick too. High gloss, you can see how nice those look with words and pictures for those of us that can't read. And in the manual, as always, we won't show you the whole thing, but in the back of the Moebius manuals, why are they nice? They've got full color chip guide, full paint guide option, so you can do like a white on the bottom, white roof with red. You can do solid color and under. You can do just the cab. They actually gave you, you know, standard two-tone, deluxe two-tone combination. They gave you options, and then the inside gives you full underhood detail, dashboard, interior, plow, everything. Everything done up. So I'm gonna get to building my version, and we'll be right back.
Thank you.
check that out. Isn't that cool? We've got the sub-assemblies all sitting together. That's how easy these Moebius trucks go together. I did notice that on all the parts on this one, there was far less flash than the other, I think the two-wheel drive F250 that I had done up. So maybe they went through the molds, made sure they were clamped better, made sure stuff was casting correctly. So we'll look at these sub-assemblies before I get paint on them. We've got our belt and pulley system right there. It's a nice looking assembly. We can get that painted up easily. We've got our rear step bumper. This is going to be a work truck for me, so I definitely want to use this bumper option. And it's nice that they include so many different options in the vehicle. The interior pieces can just all get painted together. They're going to be the same municipal boring color. We got our drive wheels that are ready to go on with their bolts in them. We got our spare. So these are all going to be nice plain Jane ordered colors. Our dashboard, as you saw, goes together, and I want you to see how those nicely those pedal assemblies go together. Then the steering wheel, which I think ran off with the cow that jumped over the moon. The pedals all go in, and then this little area here is where the steering wheel actually locks in. So you can actually get that all together and insert that in the interior in one piece when you're all done and ready to go. The hood just needs to be painted our top body color. We've got our battery, and on this one it has a jack and a reservoir instead of a reservoir bag. We've got our brake booster and master cylinder. That's two halves glued together. You can see it makes for a nice assembly on there. These are the shift levers we need, four-wheel drive and for the transmission. So those will be going into the interior. We've got our radiator, which was just kind of flying around loose in the kit, came off of its tree. This is the air cleaner I choose to go with, the larger air cleaner for the larger engine option. Our exhaust system and our radiator lines. The rest of this stuff is used on a different model. So we have spare parts. We've got our heater hoses. Those are right there. We definitely need this one. It's a plow truck. It's going to have a heater in it. And then the hood over here. Let's slide stuff back. Take a look. There's our steering wheel hiding with that plastic tough wheel. You can see that assembly right there. And that keys together as you saw in the assembly process. Now let's get the truck and everything. We got our plow. We can take a look at the box. Those lock together. You could have the tailgate open, closed, do whatever you want with it. I always have them closed on mine, unless I'm like hauling something. But we've got our bed there. Our trim's gonna go on the side, which is cool that it's already done up in the chrome for us. That goes together and locks together. Don't cut off these four tabs. That centers it on the frame and lets it push in and hold tight to where it should be with just a couple of drops of super glue. So that is a very nice assembly. No holes, no issues, and it assembles square every single time without having to measure things up. We've got our cab. I did drill the holes for those cab marker lights. I want them on my truck. And underneath, we've got the interior tub pressed in so it would sit on the frame. On this one, they did not mention gluing in that cross piece to center it on the frame. You just use these large holes back here. Those go into the large holes in the frame right there. So you know exactly where the cab is supposed to go, and it sat down on there nicely. And then these little runs here go into these slots here, right on the frame that we'll look at closer in a second. So we've got the cab ready. The door panels will be detailed, and then they attach with these large tabs. So you don't have to worry about that. And if you did glue this slightly a little off, when you put your door panels on, it will fit perfectly once you get it in there. The engine, check that out. Nice transmission, oil filter, manifolds, distributor, breather, PCV hose, coil, water pump, fuel. Everything is on that engine. It's just magnificent. And this one, you don't need to assemble that cross member or engine mounts or anything. On this one, it will just drop in perfectly and line up with its pins here. A pin and a hole into the frame, and it will just key in. Probably don't even need glue on the frame itself. I've got pretty much everything glued together because this is going to be, you know, all black and then detailed as far as I go. So we've got the heavy duty springs front and rear. You can see those extra leafs and stuff. And then the leafs for the four wheel drive and the solid axle on this one. We've got our long shock absorbers mounted, our spare tire carrier. I'm gonna throw the spare tire in the bed so they can get to it easy instead of waiting for it to be all packed with snow and unable to move. We've got our drive shafts. Those aren't even glued in. That's how nicely they fit. Our front drive shaft, or our main drive shaft, is glued in, and then we can just gently lift it up, line it up with the engine, and press our engine into place. But yeah, we got our shock towers on there. We've got our steering and our steering components all glued in there. What a nice assembly. Really well done. Love the four-wheel drives, and check it out. It sits perfectly flat. It's not three-wheel motion. It didn't have any inherent twist in it or anything. It just sat perfectly flat on the wheelbacks. So that's awesome. That's set to go. And then the newest part from Moebius is the plow. I've got it in two assemblies because this will all get painted one color. You have multiple options with the plow for different hydraulic ram lengths, depending if you want the plow to sit perfectly straight or off to either side. And then I don't see this mentioned anywhere, but I think that's the control box. We can toss that in the cab, you know, on the dashboard or something like that. We can glue that in. We've got different lengths hydraulic rams for the lift pump that will lift that arm up. And then you've got different headlight options. I went with the larger square ones, figuring a municipality would order the larger lights so they could see. You also have round lights, depending on what style plow, what generation, what you think they would have come with. But I think any municipality that I saw would want a lot of light off the front. So they went with the larger squared off style headlights with the larger turn signals built into there so that they could be safe and have their lights flashing as well and stuff like that. We've got our edge of the plow indicators, our little flags there. We can glue those on later because they are quite fragile. We've got an extra plow skid. These ride on the ground on the back of the plow. We've got our wear blade on there. We've got our springs. We've got our plow mount. Then you see that large pin there and how it's opened up. That allows us to join those two together. Your hydraulics, trying to line this up on camera. Your hydraulics go onto those pins under there. So it kind of like sandwiches itself together. All right. And then the top of the plow mounts up here. And then you can have your plow aimed at those angles and the hydraulics will correspond. So that's as simple as that is. Just decide where you want it located and how you want everything to go. We've got the chain to come. The chain will go from those pins to the little pins on the chain carrier down there. We'll super glue everything into place. So we've got to get everything painted up. If you're going to be installing the plow on yours, you have to hog out these two holes in the front of the frame to fit those two slots. So when they go together, you can push your plow up in there, glue it in securely, and have it all ready to go. That's a lot to talk about because there is a lot to do. I'm going to get my parts into paint and I'll see you over there. let's pause after all that work, all the assembly and painting and everything, and let's take a look at where we are before I seal the truck up. Now, I am going to do some light snow effects, as you saw me start brushing them on the vehicle, on the wheels and tires. See how cool that is once that dries? That gives us the nice texture, and I rub it out of the tread because snow doesn't stay on the tread very long, but it stays packed in between the treads quite a bit. And then it stays surrounded around the side, always packed in the side biters and all that stuff. The spare tire won't have any because that I'm just going to toss in the bed. It just looks so neat. I didn't want to lock it into the frame. And being a work truck, they'd want that sitting up where they could grab it. If it's packed underneath, you do a lot of plowing, the snow swirls, it packs up. If you live in snow country, you're well aware of that. We got our work bumper. That's going to be bolted on the back. I'm doing a fairly new truck, so I'm not going to rust it or crust it or anything like that. It's just going to have been used for, you know, its first season of snow plowing. For that snow, I was using light ivory color. It doesn't matter. You could use bright white, whatever you want. But I know that snow, once it hits the ground and swirls, doesn't stay clean for very long. So we've got all those details on there. I've got the cab ready to go, and I just love that trim. I did a black rub down the center since it's a work truck, and then we got the chrome on the outside. Super well done. I wish trim on every vehicle was like that. Painted black behind the grill. These grills, usually with these large pins, just press in nice and tight. And that'll look pretty awesome on there. Then we've got to take the hood off. I've got the trim pieces on the hood, the chrome all the way around. All that's ready. Got under the hood, did the fenders. Just got to attach everything and then slide it all down onto the cab of the truck. And then we got to put our interior in, but we've got the master cylinder, the booster, the reservoir tank, the battery, and the jack all in there. Got the glass all pressed in and mod podged in. The same thing I used to attach the headlights and the lights on the plow like you saw. Got the interior done with the dashboard. I didn't use the dash decals on this one. These Fords have such a prominent detail on that dashboard that it's rarely needed. Sometimes I use them, sometimes I don't. A lot of times I like hand painting them. With our door panels, I don't even know if they even offered. I didn't see any chip codes for the orange, but it doesn't matter. This is the work truck I wanted to make. So mine, it's going to be that way with the orange dash, the orange trim on the doors, and the black interior. That's how I wanted my truck to look, and that's how I built it. The box is attached. It's actually, the pins are in place. It holds it on real tight. Again, the trim all the way around there is so awesome. Got our tailgate. This is a bad line here because I will be using the fall wood tailgate. Probably wouldn't be on a work truck, but that's just too cool not to put on the back. So that'll be there. That'll cover that up. Otherwise, I did the trim with the handle and everything. Got our taillights in. Those assemble so easily. And the trim on the other side, and I haven't weathered the box or anything. So that's all set. Did the frame, did the snow powder and dust that gets all underneath them when you start plowing and it swirls on the front sides of everything. Got our radiator mounted and our line. Got the engine in there. That looks awesome. It just needs its air cleaner and the air cleaner's decal once we're all done to sit on top there. But we painted everything by hand. Got all the drive shafts in place. Got the exhaust in there. So that thing looks cool. Looks all snowy and used up. Then we've got our plow mount. Got that one a little bit thicker with the snow. Got the cool headlights in with the turn signals. Got our hydraulic rams painted and the pumps and everything. So that's a nice accent piece. And then I did the same with the plow. Made it look a little dusty. Now I'm going to go farther on the front and the back of the plow. I'm going to go farther on the plow and some of like underneath the fenders and stuff once I get going. I bought these products years ago. You could also, if you don't want to use a specialized product, this is just a very thick, gooey paint that looks like snow. It's kind of crumbly and grainy. They put like a probably like a light sand texture in it or whatnot. You could buy products like that, or you can take white glue or white paint like this and stir it into baking soda. Not baking powder, that would turn out horrible. Baking soda, granular like that, stir it in and make a big mix of it, and then apply it with a thick brush, dab it in, pack it in, shove it around with a brush, it'll give you the exact same effect. But I happen to have these from other projects, so that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna finish the vehicle, I'm gonna decal what I want, I'm gonna pack that snow in it, and we'll come back for the final. Welcome back for the final of the Moebius 125th scale 1972 F250 four-wheel drive with snowplow. I keep saying this every video, the names on these things have to keep getting longer and longer and longer. It builds up into a beautiful kit. You will notice one thing, I know the complainers and the whiners will right away, is that the cab trim and the bed aren't perfectly lined up. That is my fault. I actually had the cab pressed down. I put the glue on it to hold it in place, set the glue, and realized I hadn't evened the two out just right. There's nothing wrong with the kit. It's just when I was holding it together, I set the glue too fast. But otherwise, it goes together fine. The final trim pieces, the door handles, the gas tank, the mirrors you choose, the wipers all go on easy. I did have to widen the holes quite a bit for the marker lights across the top. They tend to be a little narrow if you use the same size hole that's stamped, so just open that up a little bit more, judge it by size. I just used my X-Acto knife to open it up, and everything glued into place and they look awesome. I used a yellow Sharpie to highlight the top of the chrome lights so it looks like they're actual lights in there. On this one, I did think it was a little easier to get the windshield in. I'm probably just getting used to it, but you push it in from behind and it actually snaps in place really, really tight without a drop of any kind of glue needed. The side windows and the back glass are attached with Mod Podge, just like the headlights and the taillights are, and so are the lights in the plow. I went with the plow slightly elevated and slightly turned so we can see more of it. Added my snow effects all the way around the truck, especially on the rear bumper where it always collects quite a bit. The decals laid down nicely. I didn't have a problem with any of that. And then, of course, I put on my special Marathon County Highway Department decals that a friend made for me a long time ago. We put those on there, on the door. They look awesome. They look like something the highway department would use to clean their own parking lots or some of these small parks that they can't get the full-size trucks into to plow up. And those snow effects look really nice scattered on the tires, around the plows and stuff. If you've ever seen real plow trucks work, you know how it swirls around and catches in the back and when you drive up into snowbanks and stuff like that. So I did my best to replicate that on a new-ish truck. They would have picked this one up in fall, so it hasn't had any chance to rust or corrode or get all beat up. It's just a nice, sharp-looking truck, and that's what I wanted to do for this one. The other highway department trucks I've done have always had a little rust to them, a little wear. This one, it's just a little dirty from the snow, and I got that spare glued into the trunk. The interior looks awesome. These kits build up pretty darn awesome and quite easily. This four-wheel drive one especially could be a first glue kit for someone moving up to any other kits like that. It goes together that easily. Even the trim on the side is easy to detail and glue together. Highly recommend it. Very easy to work on kit that I had a lot of fun with. I want to thank Model Roundup for sending this over. They just got these back in stock. They sold out. They got more in stock from Moebius. So I will list in the description where you can snag yours. And as always, when you get your model, you build it your way. Have fun with it. Smile. Realize it's just a hobby. Merry Christmas to all my cool followers and watchers. And we will see all of you at the next review.